Welcome to Bot Hostage Diplomacy. We work to free hostages and the unjustly detained around the world. Together with their families, we share their stories and let you know how you can help bring them home.
Now, when it comes to using the family to get for Russia to get what they want, if that's the case, they've picked the wrong family, because I'm not going to carry water for the Russian authorities.
These are some of the most courageous and resilient people among us.
I never thought that my mother, Nahi Tagavi, will ever have a link to negotiations in Vienna about the JCPOA. That's so crazy.
People who have never given up hope.
Trevor told his girlfriend to tell me to be strong. So I'm trying to be strong for Trevor.
You know, if Trevor can cope with what he's dealing with, exactly. we can sure cope with the stress.
People who will never stop working to reunite their families.
We'd like to meet with the president. We believe that, you know, he's surrounded by lots of experienced and educated advisors. But I don't believe that any of them have ever had a child taken hostage by a foreign country, especially not a superpower like Russia.
And we'll be right there by their side until their loved one comes back home.
Because if enough people care, then the right people will care enough.
I'm Darren Nair, and I've been campaigning with many of these families for years. When I first started campaigning with these families, I noticed they struggled to get the media attention they needed. So I decided to create this podcast, which is a safe space for the families to speak as long as they need to about their loved ones and what needs to be done to bring them home.
Nobody can prepare you for what our family is going through. Even if someone had told me 1 year before, in 1 year this is going to happen, prepare yourself, that's impossible.
Thank you for listening, and welcome to Bot Hostage Diplomacy. Welcome to Bot Hostage Diplomacy. French citizen and tourist Benjamin Briere has been wrongfully imprisoned in Iran since May 2020. He is one of seven French citizens currently wrongfully imprisoned in the country or prevented from leaving Iran. The French Foreign Ministry has referred to them as state hostages. Iran is notorious for arresting innocent foreign nationals on false charges and putting them in prison for years for the purpose of extracting concessions from their home country. This abhorrent practice is state-sponsored hostage-taking, also known as hostage diplomacy. Last month on 28 January, Benjamin started a hunger strike and his family are very concerned for his health. We had the honor of interviewing Benjamin's sister, Blandine Briere, in September last year. We tell all the families we interview that we will keep campaigning by their side until their loved ones are back home, and we mean it. So we'll keep you up to date on their cases through SITREP pods like this one, or breaking news pods. Today, we have the honor of speaking to Blandine Briere once again. Blandine, I'm so sorry for what you, your brother, and your family are going through. Thank you for joining us once again.
Yeah, thank you.
Blandine, for our listeners who haven't listened to our previous episode, can you please give them a summary of what happened to your brother Benjamin, as in what he was doing in Iran, his arrest, and where he has been detained?
Benjamin was traveling in Iran. He entered in Iran in December 2019 with his van. He was just a tourist visiting Iran with his van, and just got arrested at the end of May 2020 without any reason. And now has been judged and accused of being of espionage and propaganda. So he's now sentenced to 8 years for espionage and 8 months for propaganda without any reason.
I'm so sorry to hear that. This is common in Iran, unfortunately. Since we last spoke in September last year, Blandine, many things have happened in Iran, as you know. There has been an ongoing revolution sparked by the murder of 22-year-old Mahsa Amini by the Iranian morality police. During this period, many foreign nationals have been arrested and wrongfully imprisoned in Iran, including French nationals. And over 2 weeks ago, your brother started a hunger strike in prison to protest his wrongful detention. At the same time, you and the families of some other French hostages in Iran held a rally in Paris to urge the Iranian regime and the French government to secure their immediate release. Bernard Felin, who is a French-Irish citizen, also wrongfully imprisoned in Iran, is in poor health As a result of complications from his own hunger strike, which he has ended recently, he needs urgent medical care. And most recently, on Friday, 10th February, French academic Fariba Adelka, who has been wrongfully imprisoned in Iran since 5th June 2019, was released from Evin prison. Now, the circumstances of her release are still not clear. We don't know if she can leave the country and return to France to be reunited with her loved ones. A lot has happened since we last spoke. Can you please tell us more about these events if you can and how they affect your brother?
Well, yes, now there are seven, now with Fariba, there are six French hostages in Iran. So there are many of us, many of them in Iran's jail. So it's just really critical and inhuman because they are all there without any reason. Yes, Benjamin started a hunger strike on the 28th of January just to, because this is the only way he has to protest against this injustice and to say that something needs to happen and he needs to be free as soon as possible. And he's just fighting. He tries to fight with that hunger strike. He's now ready to put his health in danger to protest and to have finally a kind of a justice or obviously a freedom. Yeah, and we are of course really happy and relieved for Fariba and all the person who were working on this freedom. So yes, she's now out of prison and we are really happy for that, but looking forward to see her at home in France. We actually did we hold a rally on the 28th of January with the other French family who were okay to talk about this and to raise their voices for press and everybody who wanted to support us in Paris. So we were really touched about how many people were there to support us, there were lots of press and medias who were supporting us as well. So we need this kind of mobilization to continue to speak about these hostages unjustly detained and to continue this fight and that no one's forgot them.
That's a good thing to do. It means a lot to the families, to the hostages, to know that their loved ones aren't forgotten and that there's a world of care out there, especially when strangers from all walks of life show up to say they support you and they want to bring your loved ones home. So when was the last time you spoke to your brother Benjamin and how is he coping?
I used to have him every 2 or 3 weeks on the phone, but it's always depends on his situation, on the guards in the prisons. It's really arbitrary as his detention. So I had him like it was 10 days ago and he was okay and he was really determined about his hunger strike and he will go further if needed and he will put his health in danger to have something, a concrete element that can help him to see his freedom. He is really exhausted of this situation and he doesn't have any elements to focus on just to keep hoping of his freedom. So it's really hard to stay aware and to stay alive, actually, to have, yeah. He's exhausted, but still determined in his hunger strike.
So what should the Iranian authorities do?
They need all the hostages free. They need to free all the hostages. That's the thing, because there are no reason for their incarceration for all of them. So we just need our people back. It's just we are just regular people with regular life and we don't have anything, they don't have anything to see with those kind of big issues or big pressure between countries. So, yeah, we just need them to come back as soon as possible. And in a relatively good health, if possible, but still after three years, it would be difficult for that. But still, yeah, they need to hurry. We need them back as soon as possible.
So what should the French government do?
The French government is mobilizing on this issue for sure. It's a priority for them, and I know they are working for the citizens' freedom. We're sure about that, but still, we have after nearly three years, we don't have any concrete elements. So they obviously need to do more and to do concrete action, to concrete sanctions, concrete I don't know what. But we need to have concrete elements to see their freedom. So more needs to be done.
What should the European Union do, Blandine? Because I know you and a few other European families with loved ones held hostage in Iran published an open letter to the High Representative of the European Union for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy. This is Josep Borrell Fontelles, and you sent him that letter last year. Did you ever receive a response?
No, we did not have any response from that letter. And nothing really concrete just happened after that. So, yeah, Iran is holding many European citizens in hostage. So something needs to be done on the European level for sure. But still, I'm still a regular person that doesn't know anything about that kind of issue and or solutions, finding solution in Europe. But something needs to be done on the higher level just to accelerate the process, to be stronger with other countries maybe. I'm the ones to analyze and to give advice from this, but I know that Iran is holding many European citizens, and I'm pretty sure we are strong country that if we go and if we are all working together, we could something could happen.
So I know you've been getting a bit more media attention recently, which is good. So what can journalists and news editors do to help?
So yeah, journalists and media in general are really helping us in that fight, and they are making sure no one forgot the hostage. They are making sure our message are important and are listening by numbers of persons. So yeah, it's really kind of teamwork because they all care about our situation and just try to help us. So that's we are really thankful for the help, just to not forget all the hostages.
So Blandine, what can the public do to help bring your brother home?
Unfortunately, there's nothing really to do. Just sign petitions, share posts on different networks, on internet shows, share their story to anyone you can. That's the only thing. Just make as noise as possible to make everyone knows those hostages situation and injustice situation.
Blandine, we're almost at the end of our interview. Is there anything else you'd like to mention?
We need really concrete action, so we need just to push our voice louder and louder. We need to make more noise about those situations to try to make them change. And I know it's not out from our level that the change is gonna happen, but still, no one's need to forget the hostages.
Blandine, we'll be right here by your side until your brother comes back home. Thank you for taking the time to speak to us today.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening to Pod Hostage Diplomacy. Thank you for giving your time and for showing these families that they're not alone, that there are good, caring people out there willing to stand by their side and help in any way possible.
Because if enough people care, then the right people will care enough. is a sort of a basic rule of thumb that is true for all campaigning.
If you haven't already, please subscribe to our fortnightly newsletter called The Hostage Briefing. It's the best way to keep up to date with the cases we're working on, as well as new episodes. You can subscribe to this newsletter using the link in the description of this podcast episode that you're currently listening to. Thanks again, and take care.